Hello guys, Kel here again from Kel's Aquariums. Another look at these. In this tank I've got a bit of sump stuff to show. I've done some more with that. Just zoom out a little bit and I can have a look at the full fat. Got a lot of Corys knocking about the bottom. Got tons of Odessas. Just getting around and in the way. Got a big fat head there. Eating some kiwi. Look, he's nailing that. Look how fat that is. And what a mess. But you know, a lot of fun as well. Not scared fish you'll ever come across. He's real jumpy. But you know, at the same time, he's the biggest fish in the tank. It's weird. I don't know why he's so scared. Some of these are having a bit of a spare, they're all coloured up nice. But yeah, it's all going alright. Oh, got a bit of an otter on the glass, an otter on a branch. And then we've got Corey Town, which is all the way down here. So there's about 12, maybe 13 of them in the tank, something like that. Just all facing a wall. Idiots. Yeah, Fatty's moved. Oh no, he's on this side now. Oh, back on the other side. So yeah, there's as for more things happening, not much is going on. Other than the bit of sump stuff I've done. So for those who don't know, this is the first video man seeing. This is it's a 5 foot by 2 foot by 2 foot tank with a big sump underneath it. It's about 39 inch of the sump. And it does a good job. I'm a big fan of a sump after having one. I've always used canisters before this. Still do use some canisters. No, I don't. I use one canister now. I've got a weird trickle filter thing upstairs. But yeah, there's a lot more fish in this tank than most of me others. So the sump does a good job. There's a massive mother plant there. It went in about a month ago, I would imagine. Just sat on top of where my ancestress lives. Now there are also three leopard frog plex in here as well, but you don't see them very often. They live sort of in these cave networks, like through here. You sometimes can see one in there, but no, there's just a Cory, another Cory. So yeah, there's some cherry barbs over this side. And yeah, all seems to be going well. Never had any problems since it's gone in, really. What's happening there? Seems to be loads of these. Trying to get through there. Is there a bit of mating going on? Is that female there? Ready to drop some eggs. But yeah, I'm going to go to the other side in a sec and we're going to look at some sump action. I've got another video with a bit, well, it might be on at the end of this. I'll show you how to make the, well, not show you, but just show you what I've done to make these baskets. But yeah, I'll be back in a sec. Also, there's a lot of stuff in my water around here. One, they're stirring it up, and two, just before the lights come on, the wave maker has a real big tidal type of thing where it sucks and pulls, and it really does drag all the muck off the bottom of the tank and gets it into the filter socks. So anyway, I'll be back in a sec. Yeah, so just a quick look at the tank from this side. All them are at this side now because they're just hungry. They're never not hungry though. So just looks a bit different. Obviously you can see some caves and stuff at this side. But yeah, I'm just going to have a look at the sump. There's a big Ancestress lives in that. Oh, just see his tail. But yeah, I've got the doors on, so I'll have to set them off. So we'll be back in another second. Right, so the sump. As I said in my last sump video, I'm going to go through it all anyway, but the fluidized reactor with a K1 micro in is going well. I have changed the pump that was running that, because it didn't have a control on it. And I was controlling it with that, sorry, that bar always gets in the way of sump videos. I was controlling the flow with that pump, with that ball valve there, which was fine, it was working really well. Other than, it made the pump make a right racket. So, I bought a cheap J-Cod, used to be J-Bow, I think, 30 watt pump. DC pump, and I've got it set on the very lowest setting it goes to, so it's running, it's a 1200 litre an hour, but it's on the very lowest, so I think it's about 300 that's actually running it, which is loads better when you can actually control it. I am in the future hopefully planning on running it from that pipe there, which is the return from my Vectra M1, because that's running at 20% power. So it could easily just have a cut off onto it there and run that, but I can't be bothered at the minute. Just putting a little pump in is just easier at this moment in time. So let's go through the sump and what changed. Since being putting that in, I got rid of two over there EM 400s. So I had three of those on, because that was a big chamber when the full chamber that's in was running as a moving bed. Just to keep all of it moving, it needed three of those 400 litre an hour pumps. Putting it into there, it's now down to one pump. As you can see, it's definitely moving, it's fine. What else have I done? I've changed from three 200 watt heaters in the final section to two 300 watt heaters. So in that section, I've got the Vectra M1, a Senai, two 300 watt heaters and a Max Spec Nano Brick, which are pretty good. Done videos on them, have a look. And then there's the bubble trap. Where are we? What that meant was I could also get rid of one ink bed controller, which is that thing there, which is a heating controller. Because I had three heaters, so I needed two of them to run them if I wanted to use these. I don't overly trust thermostats on heaters very much. So this works, this is sort of double safe, if you will. The heaters are set to 26 degrees or 27 degrees. No, 26, sorry. But this keeps them at 25, give or take. This will go to 26, give minus. It'll go from, sorry, 25 to 26. Jesus, getting your words out. Right, yeah. So as you can see at the minute, it's 25.3 in the sump. So it let me get rid of one of them and a heater. So that's two air pumps, a heater and a heating controller, just from a bit of jiggery pokery in the sump. Miles better now. I have also taken, last time I had two pieces of Japanese matting, or as we can see here, or as you can see there, there's a piece out. So the first section is three filter socks, so two 25 microns, and then that one is I've got them at 150s now, just trying different sorts. As you can see, that one needs replacing, not taking out another one, putting in, and that one washing out. This is what I've been doing today, and I say there'll be a video at the end of this. At the end of this video, there'll be a bit more spiel on this. So what I've done is, it comes through the mechanical filtration there, which gets rid of more stuff. And then it comes out of there, and then it's going to go through this, which is EHAM mech. So the bottom section of this, I built a cage basically, just to make it easy, is EHAM mech and EHAM biomech. So that's technically classed as biological and mechanical, but it isn't on the same level as a bio home or something like that. It's just nowhere near as porous as that magic there. The EHAM mech is just the hardest sort of ceramic noodles you'll ever come across, you know, just ceramic rings that, I mean, bacteria will form on the surface and the inside, but there's no pause for it to be a real good biological filter. But I've built that, and that's quite easy to take in and take out. I've built some new lids, obviously, as you can see, just to accommodate. There's three lids on that now. There used to be one big one, but now it comes off in three parts, which is pretty awesome, because I very rarely take this side off. I only ever really take that off, so to get at this, because that don't get touched very often. So that's cool, and obviously the one at that end I take off now and again if I need to do it, because that's a separate lid. All built out of just polycarbonate twin wall, or twin wall polycarbonate. But yeah, so I've put that in, and then as I say, it's just got a ridiculous amount of bio media, as well as the moving bed K1, and then as well as that technically being some bio mech, and that just being mech. Then it goes into a fan filter pad, and then it's into the Japanese matting, which is basically there as just a last ditch. If anything does, if it like starts to overflow, if I don't take care of it, which is very unlikely, unless I'm ill, and it starts overflowing, there's still some what'll catch any muck that gets through all this before going over. So yeah, that's the sump. It's doing really well. I'll have a bit of a cheeky closer look at that cage in situ. I'm going to just pause and go to there now, because I've got to get up and, I'm getting on. You'll hear me groaning. Nah, there was no groaning. I'm not that bad. So, lid off, as you can see. Just made a thing cut around there. So that's what I made. And I've even built... This is all going to be weird, just because of... I've even built some handles into it so it can just be lifted straight out. I'm not lifting it all the way out, but that's the plan. And it also holds the filter floss in place quite well. So look, I can just get it flush sort of against the filter floss, as you can see there. But yeah, it just makes it easier than putting it in bags in there. I might even do the same for this one, build some big crates. But as you can see, there's a lot of bags of stuff through there, bags on bags, and then they go all the way around that corner. There's tons of stuff. Yeah, so what made me laugh was made this in white to match the rest of the thing, but used black tar wraps. When I actually did all my wire tidying over there, I used white tar wraps on a black leg and a titty. But yeah, so that's also a battery backup, so the pumps run if everything goes to cock. So yeah, that's basically it. There's also running the Senai, I've said before, instead of buying the wireless thing for the Senai, which is 150 quid, which that's all it does, I use a little cheeky Intel Nook, just a cheeky, I think it was about 80 quid, and it was a quad-core Celeron, and it does fine. It also does other stuff. It used to run my CCTV cameras as well as the Senai. But yeah, so I'm very happy with all this now. I think it's going to stay very similar to this for a long time. So I'm putting the lid back on. As you can see, just push them flush. That just stops a good bit of condensation. Definitely worth doing if you've got a sump that's not got lids on. Get a bit of polycarbonate and cut it on. It's solid as a rock. I tried just Perspex and it sagged. But with this being the twin wall, it doesn't move. So yeah. And as I say, I use Ultra Reef overflows, which are there. Two outflows and one back in. And everything works good. And then there's a wave mecha, which you can't really see because of glare, because I've got the light on. So I'm going to feed these idiots in a minute. Bear with me. Lights off. So yeah, now you can see. Look, there's a wave mecha in that corner. But yeah, on the whole, it's all going well. I'm going to build something into the side of that door to actually hold all me bits and bobs and the siphon and stuff, because I got angry yesterday that my siphon won't go in the bucket very well, and I just smashed it to bits. Anger management. So I'm going to build something so it hangs real perfect on the back of that door. But anyway, thanks for watching. Bye.
Hello again guys, Kelly here from Kel's Aquariums. Just doing a bit of sump upgrading. So I just moved my glue gun, I ain't actually using it. I'm just building myself some baskets. out of just some white egg crate. I've got white and black. I've just had it for ages. I've done loads of other stuff with it over the years. Because my sump's white, I thought I'd use the white. Just in my garage doing a bit of action. So, yeah, just built that. It's about the right size. It's a little bit shorter because the way the sump is, the lip, it's got like a lip on one side. So to get it in, it needs to be a bit shorter unless you want to have to mess about, and I don't. So I've got a plan for that. I'll show you it all in a minute. I'm just about to make it a bit taller because in my mechanical stage, it goes through three filter socks. And then currently it just goes through a pad and then through some Japanese matting and then into the biological chambers, which again we'll look at in a minute. But what I want it to do is go through some like biomech. You know, like I've got a lot of EM mech and EM biomech. And it's just sat in bags. So what I'm going to do is build this so it goes through my filter socks, then into this, then to the pads. And then with this being in a crate, I'll just be able to take it out, wash it when I need to, back in. Because I change the pad every week. This will also keep the pad where I want it because it'll push it against the Japanese matting. And yeah, just a bit of egg crate cut and a few little tie wraps. Just cutting them with them. And then off we go. So I'll be back in a bit. So, built a big media basket. I've got handles so you can pull it out. And it's solid. I mean, it's solid as a rock. That's a dickhead like a monkey, just smashing it to bits. And it's only held on with tie wraps, real little tie wraps, as you can see. But it's solid, it doesn't really move. That's me trying to... You can't actually move it left or right. It doesn't, distort, it doesn't misshape. So, in theory, we're done. I'm going to go and fill it up. Well, I say fill it up. I've got enough stuff to fill the first section out and already in the sump. So I'm going to do that, and then I'll put some more stuff at the top. And we'll see how it goes. But yeah, little cheeky basket. It's hard to actually see what I've done when it's against a... when it's against white, and it's white. But yeah, just a little hole in it just to use as two handles. And off we go. Hello, so all we've got here so far, just gonna, I ain't quite sat right yet, but is loads of EM mech, which is rubbish for biological. Well, it ain't rubbish, it'll all coat, but it's real hard. There's no porosity, so you don't get anything on the inside. Now this stuff is a little bit better. This is EM Biomech and it's fully seeded. That's been in my thing for years. There's some Substrat Pro in there. This is all just going to be used basically. I mean, it will hold some biological media, but this is all mechanical. We'll go through the full sump in a minute. But yeah, I'm just showing you how it's going to sit. So as you can see, a big bag of that. You know, loads of that. That'd be two full trays in an Eco Pro 300, whichever the big one is. So that'd be two full trays of that, and this would be another two full trays of actual biological what comes with that. Even though it's not the best, it's not bad at all. So there's going to be quite a lot just in this tray. I mean, I'm just going to give you a little look, but oh, look at all that bio on Maxi. Oh, it's ridiculous. But I'm just going to do it now, so I'll be back in a sec. Right, so semi back in the saddle. I'm going to do a proper video on this later, but this is just a bit of one just on this thing we've just been building. So as you can see, there is a big crate, just holds all that biological. Then there's the pad, which just makes sure nought gets into here, or not much gets into here. But yeah, I mean, they make sure not much gets into here either. There's three of them to go through, three pads which need replacing very soon. Or at least this one does. I always do after a clean. You clean your tank and then you stir up all the muck and then it collects loads in these. But yeah, so that's the idea. It goes through the three socks there. So two in that back section, then they go into this final one. Through all this biomechanical, so it's mostly mechanical. Then through a fan pad. And then just in case anything does get through, it gets caught up in this Japanese matting, which is also pretty good biological. Because, I mean, it's just, I mean, it does the job. However, it's nothing compared with the big moving bed and the about 5 kilos. Is it 5 or 6? I think 5 kilos of Bio Maxi Ultimate. And then I've got a couple of kilos of just Bio Home general, I think that's just ultra. Then there's Siparax and all the other action in there. But yeah, there's a lot in there. I think all in we've got about 15 kilos of gear in, and then a moving bed. So we're going well. So anyway, that's just a quick tray for the sump. We'll do a video on this tank and the sump later, so we'll do a full action. But yeah, seems to be running good. As I said, I've put some handles in up there, so you can just, and out she comes. But yeah, I'm quite happy. So, nearly bend it then. Well, I fell. So, thanks for watching. Bye.